superstars of World Championship Wrestling and the NWO collide in some of the most important, some of the most heated matches you'll ever find anywhere in the world. And the only way you can see it is on Sunday, October 27th, as Slim Jim presents WCW's Halloween Havoc live from the MGM Grand in Las Vegas, and only on pay-per-view.
Look at the mug on that. Look at the mug on Dick Slater. You talk about mean, rough, and ready. These guys here now, they are really close to that public enemy level. You know what I'm talking about.
But let me
throw something else on you that needs to be done. Even more than all this stuff we're talking about. Sting needs to be brought back into the fold here at WCW. Apologies were sent out. We talked about that. You did too. You went overboard.
Profusely is the word, yes.
Yeah. So bottom line, brother, the franchise player, he needs to be in the fold. I hope there are somebody talking to him right now as we speak here on Saturday night.
We're going to see Lex Luger later on. I'm going to talk to Lex Luger about Sting's statement.
Good.
Statement that Sting made a week Monday on WCW Monday Nitro, where he basically made himself a free agent. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the opponents for Rough and Ready here, Chris Jericho, the youngster who has been nothing less than a sensation, and Jim Powers. What a team this is.
It's a good team right here, and they're accompanied to the ring by the master of motivation. We're talking about one Teddy Long. He can motivate anybody, but he's got to get them ready because Rough and Ready. You know, Mike Enos can get you down on the mat and really be wearing you out. And old Dick Slater come in and be stomping on your head. And that's, I'm telling you, they are a threat here at WCW with a big boys play.
Nick Patrick is the referee once again here in this match. And let me say something as we're talking about referees right here. My hat goes off to Randy Anderson. This past Monday on Nitro, when it all went down with the NWO, when those thugs, when those gang members came out and did what they did, Randy Anderson did the right thing. He took off his tie, he said, this is not WCW, I'm out of here. He left. It was the right thing to do.
It was a good call.
But we noticed how Nick Patrick came in.
Nick Patrick made
the calls and called the match.
Yeah, and look at this right now. Like, he's just going through everything just by the letter. But I guarantee you.
Dream he has been, really.
Hey, we're talking about probably the best referee in the history of professional wrestling, Nick Patrick. But that came a time just a few months ago to where he kind of strayed from the path of righteousness, if you will. And now I label him a member of the NWO. I'm the only one that keeps saying that. Even got cards and letters from people, because I guarantee you when something really bad at stake, big at stake, Nick Patrick right in the middle of it. Now look at him now. See, calling it right down the middle.
Yes, he is.
Well, hush my mouth. Maybe I should change my thoughts.
And he's got an argument going on with Teddy Long. Teddy Long, one of the people out front as well, pointing the fingers at Nick Patrick. And they've got an argument going on right now. And here's Dirty Dick Slater. This is where Chris Jericho does not want to be. But he'll get an education in the corner. Seems he's learned a lot already. Victory roll out. He goes. Actually, he caught a monkey flip. Scoop slap. Pick up. Down goes Dick Slater. Chris Jericho.
Yeah. I like this Chris Jericho, man. He's a good one right there. But he's in one of the real wily veteran. Very unusual to see Buford Dick Slater start this situation right here.
Did you say Buford Dick Slater?
Buford, he got his name a long time ago, named after Buford Pussle, the bad guy that was around there in Tennessee somewhere. I named him Buford way back. Because he was just mean and ornery, and he don't care a stick. He cares a fist that'll knock anybody out, as young Jericho found out. Buford.
Certainly Rough and Ready wanted a shot at Harlem Heat. They wanted a shot at Colonel Parker and Sherry as well. But I know they're glad to see Public Enemy, the World Tag Team champs. They would assume go up against Public Enemy as they would Harlem Heat. But for Public Enemy, their next date is coming up at Slim Jim Halloween Havoc live at the MGM Grand in Las Vegas, when they will face the Outsiders, Paul and Nash, for the WCW Tag Team. Oh, my goodness!
They both went outside and Slater went on and hit Powers, and you see Nick Patrick there spending a lot of time with Jim Powers.
Well, he sure is. Meanwhile, watch out on the floor. Chris Jericho up and back in.
Boy, Nick's attitude reminds me of somebody. I can't put my finger on it.
Try real hard.
Well.
Hey, pick up. Reverse neck breaker that time. Mike Enos. Missed. Well, Chris Jericho.
Jericho needs to make a tag right here to Powers.
Jim Powers, truly one of the most powerful men And I start looking at that upper body development, look at those arms, if you will, and sending now from one corner to the other, Mike Enos. Back drop. Down.
Well, he got him up high right there. He looks good. He can't make a mistake right now. Here's a pin going for the cover.
One, two, got a two count, kicking the back of the head. Chris Jericho cuts off Dick Slater.
Yeah, and we'll see you later, Jericho.
Well, he landed on his feet, but yeah. Slater met him hard. In the ring still, the legal man, you see him right there. A fight going out of the floor.
Wow.
Trying to backslide.
He's got him.
Got him over. One, two, he sees.
Hey, Nick, Nick Patrick was looking right at his legs.
He was.
Of course he was.
He looked up and saw the feet and still made the three count. And Jericho and Powers, Teddy Long there, irate.
What I'm trying to tell you is how can you sit down and count one, two, three,
testify.
And the guy's feet are on the rope?
Testify.
Tell me that.
Don't you think, as long as I've been refereed, if a man's feet are on the rope, that I would have seen it? And who are you to question my authority with your track record as an official, Teddy Long?
Hey,
you can make about that for a while, mister.
You know, I'm going to try to get Nick Patrick. Get
let me interview him.
Now, let me do it. Let me talk to him. You may...
Elbow. I'm gonna tell you what. You see right here was a nice move, and Enos had him in a situation right here. He goes for the backslide. Now fans at home and y'all on the radio, I'm telling you what's happening. Nick Patrick is looking a right up and sees them feet on the rope. Bad call, Nick Patrick. Tony Schiavone gonna get over and chat with him. Ask him what he was looking at. Go ahead, Tony.
All right, Dream, thanks a lot. Nick Patrick, come on in here if you will. You know, I've tried to be very fair to you. Some people have not. But it was pretty apparent to me, at least I thought, that you looked up and saw the feet on the ropes but still made the three count. Can you answer that?
That's ridiculous. Don't you think as long as I've been refereeing, if the man's feet would have been on the ropes, I would have seen that and I would have called that. But I do have a few things that I want to clear up while I'm out here since you did invite me out here. The one thing that caused the most damage to WCW at War Games. You know what that one thing was?
What was that, Nick?
That one thing was the rumor that Sting had turned NWO. And you know who spread that rumor?
Well, I know a lot of people did.
Well, you're the main one that I heard spreading that rumor. And there's another thing I'd like to get straight. I listen to the commentary an awful lot, and I've heard Dusty Rhodes saying that I've sold my soul to NWO. Well, that's another blatant lie. I am WCW all the way, and I proved that at the last Nitro when everybody walked out. All the WCW people turned and run like cowards. All the announcers, even so-called head referee Randy Anderson, he pulled off his tie, and he was out of there. But who's the man that stayed and made sure that law and order was carried out for the rest of the evening? Who's the one man that had the guts to stand up and face these guys off? Referee Nick Patrick. I want to say one thing to all you WCW fans out there. As long as I'm here, you don't have a thing to worry about.
We'll be back.